Hey guys, this is Sacharita again. I hope everyone is doing great after the CAT results. Well, as you know, today's topic is discussing about the B-school criteria, different B-schools based on your CAT scores. Before we start, I would again like to wait for about 2 minutes so that everyone else can join. Vivek is also joining us on this today as a co-host of mine, and he'll be joining us shortly. I'm going to wait for 2 minutes. Meanwhile, you all can hit like and share it with your friends and let everyone know that there's a live event going on based on the B-school selection. So, so whenever you guys are ready, and I'm ready after 2 minutes, we'll start. Okay, so I guess I'll start. It's high time that I start. One thing I would like to tell you guys is make sure that whatever information has been given, you either take down some pointers and try to understand what your percentile is and try to align that with whatever we are saying, and jot down the points. Or maybe later on also you can see the video and maybe ask us questions about it. If you have any questions again during the seminar, please put your comments below and we would get back to you at the earliest, just right after the seminar. Before I start again, I would like to introduce myself. I think some of you have interacted with me over Messenger or Facebook. And also some of you have attended my previous live session on how to fill the SIBM form. So again, I would like to introduce one more time. I'm Sucharita Banerjee. I am currently an MBA from Tilburg University, Netherlands, specializing in marketing and strategy. I have worked in in Netherlands, I've worked in AkzoNobel, owning the brand Dulux. I used to work there in their global digital marketing team. Before this, before my MBA, I was working with Vivek. We were running Time Goa together, and I've counseled so far. I've counseled more than 1,500 students and helped them for their B-school applications, counseling. I also took some of the verbal classes. So if you guys need any help from me, please don't hesitate. Do contact me, and I'll be posting my details and Vivek's details at the end of the session. So you can contact us. We are also having courses for the group discussion and personal interview rounds for the business schools. So as you know, there is one course which is for a single interview session wherein we give you an interview, unlimited help and assistance on WhatsApp, and at the same time we also review your SOP and essays. This course has already started. Some of the students have already joined. There's one more course. It's the more comprehensive version of the course, which has about 40 recorded videos. We have 4 interviews, which will be taken by the current top executives from multinationals who are already graduates from IIMs and Excel. And at the same time, there will be also SOP and WAT assistance and a lot more things. For more details, you can go to our Facebook page and offers or the shop section and check all our details. Everything has been given there. Now, today, before I go into the main details, I would just like to tell you how we are going to do it. So what we have done is as per the CRISIL rating, there are about more than 3,000 colleges in India. So I'm not going to give you all the 3,000 colleges. Obviously, it will take a lot of time. But what I'm going to do is I have taken the top colleges with a very good ROI or a return of investment, which you all call it as, and also based on their credibility and the reliability of the colleges and the quality of students which the colleges have, the activity clubs, faculty members, everything. Based on that, we have actually come up with a list, and we have segregated this entire event into parts. So first of all, what we have done is we have we'll be discussing about colleges based on percentile. So which means that we'll be talking about colleges ranging from 90 above percentile. Then there will be colleges between 80 to 90 percentile that we would be talking about. And again, we will be talking about colleges between 70 to 80 percentile. We are mainly concentrating on CAT and ZAT also. Wherever we could use CMAT, we have used CMAT. But right now, we are not discussing about CMAT. We are mainly focusing on CAT and ZAT. The second part which we are doing is, apart from dividing the colleges with respect to percentiles, we have also divided the colleges based on the current situation with respect to your work experience. So the first part is, the segments will be the people who have 6 months of experience, the people who doesn't have any kind of experience have a gap of about 6 months. I'm sorry about that. The second part is people with work experience. Under the work experience criteria, there are 2 segments or sub-segments, as you can call it as. One is for the people who have more than 2.5 years of experience. And the second one is for people who have less than 2 years of experience. Why we have done it in this way is, although we all know that written scores are very, very important. Most of your weightage is given to your written score. But nowadays, colleges are being extremely careful about who they hire, and they just want to hire the cream of all the students. So they ensure that they also take into consideration your work experience details as well. So I would be discussing about the colleges which ranges from 70 to 90 percentile, and 90 to 90 above would be discussed by Vivek shortly after I complete my session. Now, one thing I would also like to tell you is, when you're applying for colleges, you all have actually, in the last 1 year, you all have gone through a lot of hard work. Everyone, I mean, you all have invested a lot of time and energy, also money, in this joining different courses. So this was a journey that you all have taken with your friends and also with your family members, because they have also invested a lot of energy in you. But this is just the first step that you all have cleared your exams. Right now, there are 2-3 other steps which are left, which is clearing your group discussion and personal interview. And at this point of time, you cannot be very choosy. There is no ego business at this point of time. Please keep your ego aside and apply to as many colleges as you can, because it all depends on, at the end of the day, where you land up, which colleges you land up, and how you perform in the industry. So it's very important that you keep your options open. Right. I would like to tell, first of all, I would like to congratulate you guys, everyone, for all your CAT results. I know there was some problem with your ZAT examination yesterday, for which it was pretty inconvenient for most of you. But right now, you can forget about ZAT and just concentrate on applying to most of the colleges that you can. Now, let me first talk about work experience. Now, I'll talk about the people who have given a gap of about 6 months. Now, frankly speaking, I have gotten a lot of responses in the morning. We had a session in the morning also, a text-based session where students were giving their doubts, posting their doubts, and we were answering to their questions. And some of the students have also asked me that they have a gap of about 6 months to 7 months in their CV, and they want to, they're not happy with the CAT score, so they want to apply once more. Should they do it or not? So I would suggest for all those people that please be a little careful, because usually, unlike a foreign university where They have a particular thing called as a gap year, where you can take a gap in your academics or in your career and go for other extracurricular activities. Indian colleges do not actually understand the importance of gap, right? So you need to justify your gap during the interview. So it becomes really, really difficult if you have no answer to it. So either what you can do is, for those people, either you join a job, take up a job, and then you can prepare again if you're not satisfied with your CAT results. Or I would suggest you to apply to as many colleges as you can and write apply to a college this year itself and do your MBA this year itself, because you cannot be messing up with your career to that extent. For the second set of people are the freshers. So they are the ones who have just graduated or are going to graduate. So for them, I would say that you all have quite a lot of a long window. Even if you guys are not happy with your CAT results or ZAT results or MBA results, you can always prepare for one more year and give it try it out next year. But again, don't give up at this point of time. There's also CMAT left, and you still have your GSAT results, so you can perform very well there. So don't take a decision right now. Still apply to colleges. Also, for those people who are going to graduate and they are thinking of writing CAT again next year, just one small tip: please don't sit back home just preparing for your exams. Please make sure that you do a job, or make sure that you are always involved in some kind of activity. So maybe you do a part-time job, join an NGO maybe on a part-time basis, and at the same time develop your skills or do something which you can show in your CV in the next year that, okay, 1 year I have not only studied for my CAT examinations, but that 1 year I've also invested my time in other activities also. So again, as I told during the last session of mine, the college wants to see how much you're passionate about, whether you're open to experiences or not, and whether you're open to different challenges or not. So this is exactly what you have to show it to them. Now, the second group of people is based on the work experience. First, I'll be discussing about the people who have up to 2 years of experience. For them, I think applying to a B school is good. An Indian B school is pretty good, because you all should be in the age group of, let's say, between 21 to 25. And that's what the average age is, about 25 to 26 in an Indian B school. So I guess this is the right time for you to do it. Even if you all want to take up one more chance and apply it for next year, you can do that, but make sure you keep on keep on doing something. Don't leave your job. Most of the Indian B schools that you can apply actually fall under this category. You all are like those people who are very will be benefited by doing an MBA from an Indian B school. The ones who are above 3 years of experience, 2.5 or 3 years of experience, just a little small tip: apply to the colleges. For you guys, colleges like Great Lakes Institute of Management, the PGPM program, the 1 year program, would be very beneficial. Apart from that, if you cross 5 years of experience, you can apply for the IIM PGPEX program or the XLRI Global Management program. Or I would suggest you to write your GMAT examination and apply to a foreign university, just like I did. The reason why I had a few years back, I had written CAT, I had converted a lot of colleges like APME and all, but then the reason I decided not to join was simply because I knew it's not going to end up anywhere. It's not going to benefit me the way it should be benefiting me, based on the profile that I have, work experience that I had, based on the my expectations and my previous academics and everything. The best way for me was to write GMAT and apply to a foreign university. Now, these things which we, the GMAT counseling and all these things, we will also be starting a course on that. So that we will be discussing later on. So if you guys feel that at this point of time, you don't get a top B school. Like, I would suggest you, for the people who are above 3.5 years of experience, apply to the top 15 to 20 colleges, beyond which I don't think you all will benefit a lot. So keep that in mind and apply to the B schools as possible. Now, as I pointed out before, now is the time for me to discuss about percentile. So I have a list of all the colleges. So I don't remember all the colleges by heart. I mean, I remember, but not in the order. So I might have to just refer to my notes. Please don't mind about that. Okay, so first college that I would be discussing will be XIME Bangalore. Now, this college requires a 70 percentile in CAT, SAT and CMAT, and there are no sectional cutoffs. The registration is still open. So people who have about 70 percentile, please, and above, please do and go and apply for XIME Bangalore. All these colleges, please note that all these colleges that I'm mentioning, the average placements will be about 8 to 13 lakhs, 13 to 14 lakhs, and the fees is about 9 to 15 lakhs. So you can calculate your ROI, and if you feel that XIME is the right option for you, please go ahead. I know quite a lot of students from XIME, and they've given a good feedback about XIME, so you can rest assured you can go there and join that college. Okay, second is GIM, Goa Institute of Management. Unfortunately, GIM has already closed their applications. But again, for people who have already applied to GIM, so the CAT percentile that they require will be about 88. ZAT is about 80, and for CMAT, it would be about 95 percentile. These are for all the general category students, not the Goan domicile students, so you know what to do. The next college is NIBM Pune. Now, NIBM Pune is specifically catered to, it's National Institute of Banking Management. So people who are interested in finance and specifically banking, please do apply for this college. It's a decent college. Registration is still open. CAT percentile is about 73. CMAT will be about 87 percentile. The next college is TAPMI. Again, TAPMI is still open. Their last date is 18th of June. Sorry, 18th of January, if I'm not mistaken. So people who have not applied to TAPMI, please go and apply. It's a very good college. The CAT and ZAT percentile is somewhere between 80 to 85. So you can be rest assured the placements are very good. Again, I know a few students from TAPMI as well, so they are doing pretty well over there. The next college is IFMR. IFMR is 76 percentile in CAT. The only criteria that they have is they require a 80% percentile in the quant section. So if the people who have bagged that, please go ahead and apply to this college. Registrations are open for IFMR. The next college is LIBA. LIBA is 80 in CAT and 75 in ZAT. The only criteria for LIBA is they have sectional cutoffs. They give preferences to your 10, 12 and graduation score, and they have a strict policy that people who have less than 60% in their 10, 12 and graduation are not eligible for the application process. So only the people who have 10, 12 and graduation, you have 60% or above, apply to LIBA. It's a decent college. And again, it's Chennai, so amazing. I mean, I always say, and Vivek also says, that always apply to a college which is in a metro city. Obviously, the non-metros are also good, but the colleges in the metro cities, why? Because there is so much of scope there. There are so many companies that the kind of interactions that we would be having with the peers and also outside would be amazing. So always try to apply to a metro city. There are colleges like XLRI and all the IIMs. They don't count because they have the Excel tag or the IIM tag behind them. So I'm not talking about them, but I'm talking about the rest of the colleges. Then we have KJ Somaya. Now, usually KJ Somaya is a college which, just one thing I would like to tell you is, I had a student before and he went to KJ Somaya. He had about 4.5 years of experience. He is very happy with the course because the kind of salary that he was drawing post before MBA was not that high and his profile was not that amazing. So he is happy with KJ Somaiya, but there are other people who have an amazing profile with respect to, like, they have been in a managerial position and they just don't want to actually, they don't feel that KJ Somaiya can benefit them. So only if you feel that you're in that category, go and apply to KJ Somaiya. For the freshers and all the other people, definitely apply to KJ Somaiya. It's an amazing college. And don't you forget, it's in Mumbai. Apply for the PGDM course. The MMS course, they also have an MMS program, which is Masters in Management program. But I'm not discussing that because for that, you need to have your CMATS course. So that we can discuss it later on. So right now it's KJ Somaiya, it's through CAT that we are discussing. So KJ Somaiya requires about 80, last year they took about 87 to 88% in CAT and SAT. It can be about 90% also. So apply to the college, they're very low sectional cutoffs. So definitely go ahead and apply. Then we have Nirma. Nirma, what their criteria for last year was. Okay, by the way, KJ Somaiya dates are at this point of time, they are not open, they are closed. But like every year, since they take also CMATS, they might open the dates. So if once they open, please do apply. For people who have already applied, you all can go ahead and keep KJ Somaiya as an option. Now, talking about Nirma, Nirma in Ahmedabad. So Nirma, last year, they made a certain structure of or eligibility criteria of hiring people, which was they require a 70th percentile. So for your under your CAT examination, but the 75th percentile is only valid if you have a 40 plus in each section. So your sectional should be 40 plus, then only you can apply for 75th percentile. Otherwise, you have they will be taking 95th percentile as an overall score. So if you feel you fall in under that category, please go ahead and apply for that. Okay, by the way, Nirma last date is tomorrow, so people who haven't applied as of now, please go ahead and apply for Nirma. The next is Four School of Management. Again, Four School of Management in Delhi, the registration is closed, but like every year, they usually open. So I would suggest you, if they open, you can go ahead. Their cutoff is usually 88th percentile. Yeah. Okay. The next college that we have is the Great Lakes Institute of Management Studies. Now, GLIM has two programs. One is a PGDM for people who have up to 2 years of experience. The other is PGPM. So that is the one-year program that is recommended for people more than 2 years of experience. Now, I think the PGPM program is closed, but the PGDM registrations are still open. They usually require a CAT or SAT score of about 85 to 90 percentile. So you can go ahead and apply for it. Next, I'll be talking about IMT Ghaziabad. IMT is closed, but again, like every other college, they might open. IMT has three campuses, as you know, Ghaziabad, Nagpur, and Hyderabad. Ghaziabad percentile will be somewhere around 90 in CAT and SAT. For there are no sectionals again. For Hyderabad and Nagpur, it's around 60 to 70 percentile. So if you feel that you want to apply, you can go ahead and apply. Hyderabad and Nagpur has an average placement about 6 to 7 lakhs, 6 to 6.5 lakhs. So if you feel that you want to, you can just go ahead and do it. Again, it's under IMT, it's under the tag IMT. So although it's not as good as IMT Ghaziabad, but it's decent. So I have, that's why I included this in the list. The next is IMI Delhi. It's an amazing college. And again, it's in a metro city, the capital city of India, which is Delhi. So definitely go and apply for it. Cutoff will be somewhere around 87th percentile in CAT. And the registrations are still open. So again, you can apply. Then we come to IRMA. So IRMA, the way they hire the students is they take your CAT or SAT scores. CAT, it will be about 80th percentile that they require in CAT or SAT. But after that, they also have have a certain course on have a certain exam on social issues or social concerns. So only if you pass that exam, you will be actually eligible for that course. So they will be taking a weightage of both the exams, and they will be and also your profile, and they will be selecting the best out of it. Last but not the least, it's BIMTECH. So it will be about 86th percentile that will be required in CAT, and it's a pretty good college, so you can apply. This was most of the colleges that I felt it's worth it. I have applied to it. If you if I missed out any, maybe you can just post your comment after the session, and maybe I'll tell you the percentile requirements for that. Right now, Vivek would be talking about the colleges above 90 percentile. So this is Sucharita signing off right now, and Vivek would take over for me for now. So bye bye. Have a nice day.
Hi guys. Let me know if you guys are facing any problems with my voice. Do let me know. I hope it should not be a concern as such, which is there. Okay, right now we'll be talking about colleges which are more than 90 percentile, which is there. Now, I am ABC have already taken out their scores, so there is no point discussing on that. Those who have gotten will have gotten, and those who have not could not have gotten in. You can blame as much as you want, but that is a criteria which everyone knew beforehand. So you can crib about it, but there is no point thinking too much about it. Now, a lot of people have basically asked, should I try again or should I take whatever scores I have right now? Now, couple of things which I would like to say is, those who have scored 90 plus, okay, especially for those who have scored 90 plus and who are thinking that this college is not good enough for me, okay, please ditch that attitude right now, because even if you're going to, even if you're going to attempt again, that attempt is going to happen only in November or December. And because you have scored 90 to get to 90 plus, and I'm assuming 95, 96, 97, 98, all those people are also there. Getting from a 96 to 99.5 is, while difficult, it's not as difficult as going from, say, 80 to a 90 percentile, the effort required, which is there. While there are a lot of people who will have different opinions, at 90, 95 percentile, you already have a lot of your basics in place. So a reasonable reappearance, so to speak, will require you not more than 3 to 4 months. Now, should I take up right now or should I wait for some more time? While it, the cliched answer is it depends, I would give you 3 things which you should not do right now, which is there. First of all, whichever college you have applied to before you got your CAT results, if it was good enough at that time, don't think it is bad just because some of your friends have got an IMA convert or IMA call or an IMC call, but you have not got. Okay, ABC are really, really good colleges. They are the top colleges in the country, but there is a slight difference. If you're not in the top 1/4 of the batch, actually 1/4 is pretty big. If you're not in the top 70 or 80 people, which is about 1/5 of the batch in any of these colleges, you're going to get a very average placement. Okay, the top investment banking, consulting jobs, etc. are available to very few people in that college. So if you are under that blind notion that I am going to go to IIM Calcutta just to get an investment banking job, unless you have an awesome profile right now, it's not advisable to take that chance. I can, from my personal experience, tell you something like this. We had a student who got a 99.5, 99.6 percentile in CAT. He converted MDI Gurgaon. He basically said that I want to do finance and I want to take only IIM Calcutta. Okay, MDI finance would have given a decent job for him. He actually ended up having a second attempt at CAT. He ended up going to Sydenham instead of MDI Gurgaon. Okay, now Sydenham to MDI Gurgaon is a huge difference compared to IIM Calcutta to MDI Gurgaon. Now, obviously, the jobs which are available in IIM Calcutta are completely different than what you will get in MDI. Those 50 investment banking jobs, but it's not that bad. Honestly speaking, it's not that bad. So please do not mess up your life chasing these dreams. Have these dreams. I'm not saying don't dream, but have these dreams for a reason, not because you have to prove to somebody that I am going to an IIM. Okay. It's like a lot of people who are doing engineering will relate to that. I didn't get into an IIT JEE, so I'll take a drop and try again for IIT JEE. I studied in IIT while it was not a BTech. I used to interact with quite a few BTech students which are there because all the hostels for all the events, etc. We used to have these BTech students. There are a lot of people who had an IIT JEE rank 200, 100, 300, 400, 500. Their main aim was to get into an IIT. After that, they don't know what to do. They were chasing probably their parents' dream or somebody else's dream. They were not chasing their own dream. They got into an IIT, but what right now? What are they doing right now? They ended up with a 5-pointer, 6-pointer in engineering. A lot of people in BITS go through the same result. There is no point chasing a dream if you cannot follow through, if you don't know what what you're getting into. Like for those who follow boxing, okay, Mike Tyson once said, or at least it is attributed to Mike Tyson, not a great role model, so to speak. But one of my classmates was a big fan of Mike Tyson before he got into all that controversy. He basically said that be careful about what you wish for, because you might actually end up getting it. Okay, so please be very careful about what you wish for, because if you don't know what you're going to get, okay, you might end up in a very, very big soup. I'm not trying to discourage you today, but I'm just trying to say that please make your ego out of it. Even if you have gotten calls, it's pretty difficult to convert them. There's a lot of effort still left. Okay, because the people who have gotten the calls have roughly the same sort of background as you are. So please do not take these things lightly. If you have got the calls, please make sure that you convert them. If you have not gotten the calls, please make sure that at least the calls that you get, treat them seriously. I'll quickly go through some of the criteria of some of the colleges which are there. Like IIM ABC, the results are already out. Lucknow, Indore, Kozhikode and Shillong. Okay, out of which Indore and Kozhikode, if you have more than 92-93% in 10th and 12th, usually you'll get a call if you have a 90 percentile in CAT. Okay, Kozhikode add about 80 to 85 percent in your graduation also, this on top of 90 to 95 percent in your 10th and 12th. Remember, the good part about Kozhikode is that it normalizes based on boards. So depending on which board you're from, they usually try to make sure that equal weightage is given to boards which are different weightages are given to boards where you can score low and boards where you can score less, which is there. Kozhikode will very soon ask you to enter your data again with your updated scores if you have, or updated work experience if you have. Good part about Kozhikode is about for women who are watching here, more than almost 50%. I think it has one of the best gender ratios in terms of colleges. I think last year or the year before, they had more women than men in the colleges, probably unheard for in an Indian MBA college, which is there. Okay, for the new IIMs, when I'm talking about the new IIMs, I'm talking about the old new IIMs, which is Ranchi, Raipur, Trichy, Udaipur, Rohtak, and Kashipur. Okay, these are the six IIMs which started in 2009-2010, which used to have a common admission process. Roughly around 96 percentile should be good enough to get you a call, with 80 percentile in each section. Okay, should be Ranchi is the best out of them. Trichy is very good. Please do join them. If you at least convert the calls, then we can decide. I will always say convert the calls before you decide. Okay. In terms of the new IIMs, we have Amritsar, Vishakhapatnam, Jammu, Bodh Gaya, all those colleges which are there. Actually, I've forgotten how many IIMs are there right now. There are 19, I know that. 19 or 20 which are there, but I don't know where all they are located. But the new IIMs, people also call them baby IIMs, will usually call it around 92, 93 percentile with certain additional riders. Usually the sectional cutoff is about 80 percentile in each section, except for Amritsar, which has about 70 percentile in each section. Now, I'm talking about general category students. OBC category will probably reduce by about 3 to 5 percentile points in each area which is there. MDI Gurgaon takes at about 95-96 percentile. You have sectional cutoff about 70 to 75 percentile in each section. Okay, so please, if you have filled up, MDI is a very good college. In fact, MDI is probably comparable to an IIM Indore and Kozhikode. Okay, it's definitely better than IIM Shillong, for sure. It's definitely worse than IIM Lucknow. You have SP Jan, you might get a score-based call, but even for a score-based call, you will need some amount of academics, which is there. The official cutoff is about 95-96, but again, they need some amount of academic profile. We had a student who got a 99.98 percentile in ZAT about 3 or 4 years ago, but he had a 60% in engineering. He did not get a call from SP Jan, either for the profile or for the merit-based call. So even though it's called a merit-based, it's actually not a merit-based call, so to speak. Just purely merit-based call, such as that. FMS, even though it has some weightage for 10th and 12th, the expected cutoff is about 98.599 percentile, with some amount of weightage for the, definitely weightage for the sectionals. Last year, they had a 40% weightage for VA, 30% weightage for Quant and DILR. And they had a composite score based on this, and then they converted that. So last year's composite score requirement was about 60, 59 or 60. The calculations are there on the website. You can check your calculations, how they will work out, which is there. Another college which is there in this range is NITI. NITI is known for its operations management. Cutoff is roughly about 97 percentile, with sectionals ranging from 70 to 75. If you are interested in operations, NITI is the mecca of operations. If you are thinking of operations in India and you are not aiming for NITI, I don't know what you're thinking about. Just because it does not have an IIM tag, NITI is so old and it has so famous for its operations degrees that not joining NITI, in spite of having an operations interest, actually does not make sense. NITI also has a pretty decent, we have students from NITI who are working as marketing managers, as product managers, which are there. So it's not bad for other branches also, even though it is known for operations. I'll give you an example of how you can look at this. XLRI is known for HR, but the BM placements of HR are comparable to that of IIM Lucknow, probably even better than IIM Lucknow's placements. So just because it is known for HR doesn't mean that the other programs are shit. Same way, I mean, if you are going to get an IIM Ahmedabad and you have a SCM HRD and you're interested in HR, I would still say go to IIM Ahmedabad, because you will definitely get a better placement in IIM Ahmedabad, which is there. Just because you want to do HR. In fact, even for tests, I would say go and join IIM Ahmedabad. Is there. But there are certain things like operations, etc., where these colleges are known for them. Okay, so if you are interested in operations, join NITI. Eyes closed, join NITI. Doesn't matter whether you have an IIM degree or not. Next is the IIT's School of Management. The IIT School of Management, out of this, the big three are IIT Delhi, IIT Bombay and IIT Kharagpur, not in any particular order. Okay, I mean, the IITians are just like the IIMs at ABC. They always have a big ego fight on which is better, which is worse, and so on. Okay, but even though I did from IIT Kharagpur, I would say IIT Bombay is a better college than IIT Kharagpur as such. you would get better placements in IIT Bombay and better companies coming in IIT Bombay. IIT Kharagpur is pretty good. IIT Delhi is also very good at this range, which is there. All these colleges will be somewhere between 10 to 20 all India. You get all type of placements except the top end finance and investment banking and strategic consulting placements, which you will get only in ABC, Excel and FMS to some extent. Maybe I am Lucknow also to some extent. So that those are the other placements are roughly the same as most of the other colleges as such. Okay, briefly rattle off some of the cutoffs required, which are there. IIT Bombay will require you about 98.5 percentile, which is there. IIT Delhi is about 98-97. IIT Kharagpur has a profile-based selection. In fact, if I apply today, I will not get into an IIT Kharagpur as of now. The rough estimated cutoff is 93-94 percentile, so all these people apply over there. Then comes IIT Madras at around 94-95 percentile. Then you have IIT Kanpur, Roorkee. Good colleges, but I would say Kanpur and Roorkee will be ranked somewhere around 30 to 35 across, which is it. You also have quite a few colleges where you have which have been inflated because of their location, like DFS and Delhi School of Economics. I think besides the fact that their fees is low, I don't find anything great about that college. Personal opinion. You have all the right to yell at me. It's a personal opinion, but I will stick by it. With such a small batch size, I don't think it's worth doing it from a place which does not have hostels or peer learning and so forth, which is there. Another thing which I would like to speak about when you're looking at B school applications, so to speak, I will not take long. I'll take another 5 to 10 minutes max. Think of it as insurance. Okay, apply to as many colleges as possible. Convert them. Conversion is a completely different ball game compared to application. Please apply and convert. Okay, you can make this decision in March, April, after you have something in your hand. It is always better to convert something and then say no to it rather than, you know, not have anything at all. Okay, last but not the least, I would sorry, there's a movie going on here. Okay, last but not the least, B schools will give you the first job, which is there. Okay, a lot of companies come to colleges like IIM Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Calcutta, Lucknow purely to hire an IIM grad to show on their CV that we have X number of IIM grads. Okay, they actually don't make them do any quality work, which is there. There are quite a few people who have gone from slightly lower B schools and become equal to people from the IIMs to there. I'll give you an example. I last worked in HSBC. This is about 8-9 years ago, which is there. When I left, I used to report to a person who was from IIM Calcutta. He used to report to a person who was from Jamnalal Bajaj. The person from Jamnalal Bajaj had an equal who was from NMIMS, Narasimhanji, and all these people reported to a person who was from Pune University MBA. And somebody said that, you know, these people will be very old. To give you the age at that time of all these people, the person from IIM Calcutta was about 34, the person from JB was about 40, 41, the person from NMIMS was about 40, 41, the person from Pune University MBA was about 37, 38. Okay, your B school does not matter. Okay, you get an opportunity of about 1 year, 1.5 years to prove yourself. After that, it doesn't matter whether you are from IIM Ahmedabad or from any other XYZ university. If you cannot work, if you cannot work in the corporate world, you're useless. Honestly, you're useless. The degree can be burnt and thrown into a dustbin. Okay, so please do not let your ego come in between when you're selecting these colleges. It's better to apply to as many colleges as possible, convert them, and then decide, rather than wondering what would have been. Okay, remember, if you're going to try again, another year adds up to your work experience. You may not have the same motivation, you may not have the same burning desire over there, and there might be certain other distractions. Just like Zad this year, something else can go wrong with you. Please use this opportunity. Whatever score that you have, make sure that you use it wisely. And last thing, a lot of people would think about fees while applying to these colleges which are there. Now, a lot of people calculate ROI based on my graduating salary versus the fees that I've paid. And FMS graduating salary is about 17-18 lakhs. Ahmedabad has a graduating salary of about 18-19 lakhs. What will you choose? IIM Ahmedabad's fees is about 20-30 times higher than what FMS's fees is. Are you going to choose FMS over IIM Ahmedabad? I don't know. A college which gives you 4-5 lakh rupees placement for 3-4 lakhs versus a college like MDI which gives you 13-14 lakhs placement for a fees of about 20 lakhs. If you're going to choose a former, you are actually not doing the ROI calculations properly. ROI is not your graduating salary divided by the fees that you've invested. That's actually a very stupid way of doing it. Your MBA degree is like a tree. You don't come up. Whereas a mango tree will probably take 5 to 6 years to grow and bear fruit. Mango is costlier than bamboo, if I'm not mistaken, which is there. Okay, so choose wisely, and I hope you like this session. If you do, please do share it with your friends. We have a couple of courses which are there for interviews and group discussion preparation. Please, if you feel free, if you want to join, please do contact us. We will be sharing the numbers which is there. Remember, the discounts for the single interview is already over. It was over on the first day itself. Today is the last day for enrolling for the full course with any discounts. From tomorrow onwards, there will be no discounts. Thank you very much for attending, and goodbye and best of luck. Bye.